Obama and the Clintons sold us out, our uranium, and with it, the security of our nation. Follow me. It's 2008. The Russians frantic, desperate to buy uranium, the key ingredient to a nuclear weapon. The Obama administration more than willing to accommodate. In fact, the whole upper tier of the Obama administration, those paragons of globalist virtue, approved the deal. But this week, we find out that as far back as 2009, the FBI and the Department of Justice had an active, large-scale criminal investigation into Russia and Kremlin-connected individuals scheming to access America's uranium, ranging from bribery, money laundering, and kickback schemes. An FBI informant, an American businessman, was wired and provided unmistakable evidence. Now, I told you a year ago that Bill and Hillary were cashing in on her State Department job with their so-called charitable foundation. Instead, it was an international money laundering operation, a veritable pay-to-play slush fund funded not only by foreign countries, but by companies and individuals involved in this particular Uranium One scheme, to the tune of $145 million. And guess what? The Clinton Foundation failed to disclose major contributions from entities involved in this Uranium One deal, violating not only Hillary's promises to the Obama White House and the Senate Foreign Relations Committee, but evidencing her consciousness of guilt. So why is this important? Folks, context is everything. The backdrop of the sale of 20% of America's uranium to the Russians was Putin's ongoing racketeering enterprise that the Obama inner circle knew about. And the FBI and our Department of Justice was actually monitoring and investigating, and yet subsequently allowed the transfer to Russia. You know the players. Follow the names. The Department of Justice, headed by Eric Holder, in charge not only of this investigation, but also on the small committee that approved the sale to Russia. The case itself handled by Rod Rosenstein. You know him, the same man who told Jeff Sessions to recuse himself, get out of the way of the Russia investigation so that Rosenstein could appoint Bob Mueller to try to connect Trump to Russia. And if that isn't the irony of all ironies. And the head of the FBI at the time, Bob Mueller, the man now appointed special counsel to connect Donald Trump to Russia. And the FBI agent handling the case, Andrew McCabe. He's the man who was handling the email investigation of Hillary. Now, you may remember his wife got $675,000 from Clinton pal Terry McAuliffe, also connected to the Clinton Foundation, because she ran with Hillary in 2016. Now, she lost, but under Virginia law, she can keep whatever cash was left from that oh-so-generous contribution. Now, at the time of the approval of the transfer of our uranium to Russia, Republicans in Congress objected on the basis of our national security. They worried that Russia helped Iran build its nuclear reactor and that the takeover of United States nuclear resources by a Russian government-owned agency would be against our national security interests. Why does this all matter? At the time that the Obama administration green-lighted this sale, Republicans in Congress objected, and they didn't even know about the criminality and the money laundering. So you asked yourself, what happened to that criminal case? The criminal case was plea bargained to a lesser crime on Labor Day weekend. The sentence, a slap on the wrist, meted out at Christmas time with none of the bells and whistles that normally accompany an international racketeering case. The informant now, who brought the case to the FBI's attention, he is still gagged by Eric Holder and then Loretta Lynch via that non-disclosure agreement where the sanction is a criminal penalty. In other words, he is barred from talking. Neither his attorney, Victoria Tensing, nor I, with a combination of 80 years of law enforcement experience, have ever heard of such a thing. But think about it, folks. It makes lots of sense. The country cannot know what Obama, Mueller, Holder, McCabe, and Rosenstein knew, and that is the sale of our uranium and the cash that went to the Clintons and their foundation, accompanied by a racketeering operation that was literally allowed to disappear before our eyes. Now Congress wants to hear from this informant, and there are three things that must happen. Number one, Jeff Sessions needs to immediately release the informant from the non-disclosure agreement. Number two, Andrew McCabe needs to be fired as number two in the FBI. And number three, Robert Mueller, instead of heading an investigation into determining whether Donald Trump colluded with Russia, should be the target of an investigation for his role in covering up the extortion scheme that allowed Russia to access America's uranium. And that's my open.